Welcome to Paco the Realtor Channel, where I talk about real estate, rants, and other things that can make our life really interesting. Hey guys, this is Paco the Realtor, broker, owner of Arch Real Estate, local expert, realtor, storyteller. Today is Ask Paco Sunday. So if you have never been to one of these sessions, Ask Paco Sunday is questions I've been asked throughout the week regarding real estate. I was in D.C. this whole week, so most questions were asked via text message, email, or phone calls. So, all right, so here's what I got for you guys today. First question is, if I'm thinking of selling my house and want to buy another one, what is the first step? Seems very overwhelming. Well, step one is to, A, find out how much you can sell your house for, and what repairs need to be done, and how much net, meaning how much money in your pocket is going to be left over. Step one. Step two, then take that information, because now you know how much money you have, and get pre-qualified to see, based on that down payment, how much you can qualify for. So that's step two. After you know how much you qualify for, now you can move on to step three, which is based on what I qualify for, X amount with payment and whatever it may be, can I afford to buy the house I'm looking to upgrade to, downsize to, whatever it may be, right? Closer to work. Those are the steps. Step one, what is your house worth? What is your net after all expenses? What's up, Eddie? Step two is, after you know your net, is to get pre-qualified and find out what your numbers are, interest rate, payment, down payment required, all of that. Then step three is, once you know that you can buy, what can you buy? And after step three, if you look on the market and see, hey, I can afford to buy in the area I want or the house style I want or whatever, then you've got all your things taken care of, all your important factors. Now you pull the trigger, put your house on the market, start to market it, do whatever repairs are required, while you're looking to buy your new house. What you don't want to do is start looking for a new house before you even have all those numbers or your house on the market. Here's the reason why. You don't want to fall in love with a house you can't make an offer on. It really is that simple. If you're not pre-qualified, don't have your house on the market yet. Even if you go in and say, hey, I'm thinking of selling my house and I love your house, can me and my agent make an offer? Then they're going to be, well, no, because you're not ready to move. Hence the problem. Okay, guys? So just that's the steps you do in what can be a very emotionally and complicated transaction. That was the first question. The second question was regarding interest rates. Are interest rates going up? Yes, they went up. They went up this week. I'm probably going to be doing a video on it this week. I'm going to attempt to do videos every other day now, a little more often, but yes, rates are going to go up. For every 0.5% of rate that goes up, it's less purchase power for you. So if you qualified for, let's say, $400,000 and your rates go up, now maybe you only qualify for $375,000. And houses are going up or down in value. Well, they're going up. So what does that mean? You're going to be able to buy less of a house at a higher payment. Rates are going up. The higher they go, the less buying power you have. Home values are going up, so houses are getting more expensive. Rates are getting more expensive, so you're going to be priced out. So pull the trigger. Don't get too picky, because then you're going to be the person that says, why didn't I buy? So that was the second question I got asked. The third question I got asked is, I'm looking to get into investment in flips. Is now a good time? Well, that depends on your goal and what you're trying to accomplish. It is always a good time to get into real estate. But what are your goals? Is it cash flow? Is it equity? Is it... is it rental properties? Is it a fourplex? Is it a singleplex? But your goals dictate what type of real estate investments you want to do, right? That's the key. Is now a good time to invest? Yes. What you invest in is dictated by what your goal is. Yes, they do. So for example, cash flow is different than equity. Long term is different than short term. What is your goal? What's up, Mary? That will dictate exactly what it is that you should be investing in. And then close the door, please. And then The fourth question was a little more complicated, but it had to do with 1031 exchanges, how they work. A 1031 exchange is when you sell an investment property and you reinvest 100%, and that's my daughter slamming the door, by the way, and you reinvest 100% of the proceeds from the purchase, the sale of that home, onto the new purchase. And if you do that in an exchange, IRS will not charge you any capital gains. They will not go after you for any money. But you have to use an exchanger and that kind of stuff, right? So that's how that works. So an exchange, if you guys are looking to do an exchange, make sure you get a good CPA. Make sure you get a good realtor who knows how exchanges work. So you are not bitten by the exchange by the IRS for doing it incorrectly and then having to pay 35 or 40% of your profit to the IRS. All right, guys, this is Paco the Realtor, local expert, realtor, broker, and storyteller. I hope you guys got a little good information out of this. I might be going live again tonight depending on what happens here. But if not, everybody enjoy the Sunday. The Dodgers are winning. If we win today, it'll be 5 in a row. We would have swept the Nets, and I think we'll only be 5.5 back. So as bad as we were, we're only about a 5.5 back from the Arizona Diamondbacks. So it's all good. What's up, Asaya? All right, guys. Talk to you later.
Hey, thank you so much for watching our videos. I appreciate it. If you really like the content, go ahead and like and subscribe to our channel. We'll be putting out a lot of content on a weekly basis, which will be real estate related, and a lot of stuff of just me ranting. So thank you. Remember, subscribe.